I, Dan Marinick, Chair of the Board of Governors of Sir Sanford Fleming College, declare this 2020 convocation officially open.
Hi everyone, I'm Drew Van Perries, Vice President of Economic and Community Development at Fleming College. I'd like to welcome everyone to our special virtual convocation ceremony for the Fleming College Class of 2020. Of course, we'd rather be doing this with having our graduates and our families and friends gathering at our beautiful campuses in Peterborough, Lindsay, and Halliburton. But of course, that's not possible. But we have created a virtual presentation for you today that'll follow the traditional program of our convocation ceremonies. You, our class of 2020, will always have a special place in the history of the college. You'll be forever recognized for succeeding during COVID-19, and you'll be called upon to reinvent and reimagine a lot of the traditional thinking as you go out into our workplaces. On behalf of all of the employees at Fleming, we would like to congratulate our graduates. We recognize the efforts you've gone to and the challenges you've overcome. And we know that you and your family and friends and your fellow alumni will make us all incredibly proud. I would like to respectfully acknowledge that Fleming College sits on the traditional lands of the Mississaugi, Anishinaabe, and Mississauga peoples. We offer our gratitude to our First Nations for their care of our earth and our relations. To open our ceremony, I would like to introduce Ashley Safar and Mary McLeod Beaver, who will offer a reading from our Indigenous Student Services team. They will also introduce the Indigenous Honor Song.
Ani Bojo Sego Nagamoe Mayenga Nidishnikas. My name is Ashley Safar, and I am the Manager of Indigenous Student Services.
Ani Bojo Nimkinap Koagin Indishnikas Alderil First Nation and Donjiba. Hello everybody, my name is Mary and I'm the Indigenous Student Transitions Advisor for Fleming College.
For those of you who may not be aware, it is within our teachings that as settlers and our visitors to this territory, we must first introduce ourselves in order to share who we are, where we come from, and our intentions for being here today.
In the past, Fleming graduates have had the opportunity to show their declaration to Indigenous rights at convocation. This year, we'll be sending a link to your Fleming email and posting the link on our social media pages for an opportunity to sign the Declaration to Indigenous Rights. By signing this declaration, you'll be committing to acknowledging the rights of Indigenous peoples and being a respectful ally to First Nations, Métis, and Inuit peoples, both in your personal and professional lives.
On behalf of Fleming College, we would like to say Chimigwech to those of you who choose to sign the declaration and thereby taking an active role in the work towards reconciliation.
On behalf of Fleming Indigenous Student Services and Fleming's Indigenous Education Council, we would like to congratulate all Fleming graduates and wish you the best on your journeys.
We would also like to introduce you to Nimki Ozwamik. Nimki is Odawa and Potawatomi from Wukwemekong unceded territory on Manitoulin Island, and he's a member of the Wolf Clan. Nimki will be offering an honor song to our graduates.
Hey, hi, 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 hi
Thank you for that greeting and wonderful song. I would like to next introduce Dan Marinig, the chair of the Sir Sanford Fleming College Board of Governors, who will bring greetings on behalf of the board. And Dan will be followed by our president, Maureen Adamson, with a special message for the class of 2020.
My name is Dan Marinig, and I'm very happy to be celebrating all of your tremendous accomplishments today in our new format. I would like to extend my most sincere congratulations to all. You have made it through a unique year, one that presented many challenges. You are here, you have a Fleming diploma or certificate, which is what you need to embark on your new beginning. Today is cause for celebration and recognition. Celebrate all that you've achieved and recognize the role that you will play to rebuild our economy and support our community. Your hard work and dedication will be rewarded. Thank you for allowing Fleming College to be part of your educational journey. We look forward to seeing you grow and prosper in the years to come. Congratulations.
Hello, and welcome to your friends and family and all of those who are able to sign in and celebrate with you for this, the most unique convocation in our collective history, Convocation 2020. I want to acknowledge that this is not the preferred method of celebration for any of us. Students most definitely, but faculty and staff are also disappointed. And having experienced many days of in-person celebration last year, I too will miss the chance to see the smiles and the relief on the faces of students, the pride of their families, and the dedicated sense of satisfaction of our faculty and staff. It is family, it's friends, it's partners, it's neighbors, it's community. Those have made dreams come true today. Because let's face it, you did not do this alone. Everyone in your lives have had a part to play. But today, it is you, the graduate, who we honor. Fleming students have tenacity and are resilient. It is you, along with faculty, who pivoted on the head of a pin to make it all work when the entire world was in crises. A crisis that has never been experienced before in our history or in the history of our family and friends. It is your agility, these soft skills, that are exactly what our economy is seeking. Your social skills are what has kept Ontario and Canada largely safe during a global pandemic. Today, we're applauding the many accomplishments of our 2020 graduating classes. And this is a full circle moment for me. I was sitting in a large room waiting to cross the stage to receive my business diploma at Fleming College many years ago. Fleming was only the beginning. That led to a commerce degree, a master's in business, and now I'm well along the way in my PhD. So right here at Fleming, that's where that all began, and this is your beginning to many, many great things. Today, we're celebrating each of you as graduates of Fleming College who are prepared to enter high-demand careers that make up our thriving economy. Every one of you have come to Fleming through your own journey, your own desires, and your own tenacity. However you got here, the only thing that matters is that you did. And the only other thing that matters is the connections, the friends, the experiences that you had and will continue to have along the way. Of course, the fact that you are a college grad from one of Ontario's finest colleges is pretty cool as well. Last year, during convocation, I talked about the technological and societal change that was occurring. This year, I do not know where to begin. But the good news is that we are in no way at the beginning. We are all in. As a Fleming grad, it is you who have become that innovative and creative community builder that will lead and guide our new normal. You have become that social leader who will not stand for racism and intolerance and will not accept a world of standing by, because bystanding is part of the problem. It is not part of the action that is needed. And it is you who will apply your skills and knowledge that you have acquired at Fleming and will continue to acquire to hold the world accountable with respect and kindness. As a graduate of the School of Environmental and Natural Resource Sciences, you are a graduate of one of the most unique programs and campuses not only in Ontario, but in Canada. You define applied research in a moment in time when universities are dipping their toe into this arena and looking for guidance. You are a valued commodity in every country around the world. You are Fleming. Now, more important than ever, the world needs you. Canada needs you. Ontario needs you. As you go out there, and let's face it, you already have, and it really isn't that scary at all. You will make mistakes. We all do. But remember, some of the most important sectors are built on mistakes, like research, applied research, drug commercialization, vaccines, and other life-changing remedies. Mistake after mistake leads to solution after solution. Fleming has equipped you with all that you need to create those solutions throughout your entire career. And Fleming is always here. We always have our hand on your back, and we always have your success in our hearts. Congratulations.
Next up, it is my distinct pleasure to introduce our 2020 Alumnus of Distinction. Phil Hurd is a distinguished business executive and a trailblazer in international events and economic development in Vancouver. His business acumen in operations, community betterment, marketing, and government relations has made him an influential leader across Canada. Career highlights include championing multi-million dollar mergers in the horse racing industry, managing the Molson Indy car race that attracted 160,000 people to Vancouver, developing a remarkable 2010 Olympic business program, and annually producing the Vancouver International Auto Show that featured worldwide automotive brands. And please join me in welcoming Phil Hurd.
Greetings, alumni. My name is Phil Hurd, and it is my privilege to be part of this graduation celebration for the class of 2020. On behalf of Fleming College Alumni Relations, I would like to welcome you as the newest members of Fleming Alumni Network of nearly 80,000 graduates living and working around the world, enhancing the vitality of our communities. The college has changed over the last 50 years. My college education taught me how to think, be prepared, be flexible, and the ability to accept challenges and changes as they arise. I hope it did that for you. The alumni network that you and I are now part of is more than just a group of people who graduated from Fleming College over the past 53 years. We are what Fleming College instills in us as students. We dare to dream. We continuously expand our knowledge and skills. We develop ourselves along with others. We create learning communities. We are innovative, and we build a better future. As you pursue your career aspirations, I encourage you to maintain the relationships you developed during what most alumni say are the most impactful, rewarding, memorable years of their lives. In the coming weeks, you will receive a Fleming alumni pin. When life gets busy, it will be your little reminder to stay connected and to remember the good times at Fleming. Class of 2020, you have worked hard to depart Fleming by completing your studies in a very challenging year. But remember that Fleming is not leaving you. The college is now rooted in you, and as Fleming alumni, your connection lasts forever. Congratulations, graduates. Today marks the day that you continue on your journey with all that Fleming gave you to become a very best version of yourself. Cheers to your success.
Thank you, Phil. On behalf of all alumni, congratulations once again to the class of 2020. You have now joined a growing network of nearly 80,000 Fleming College graduates. Stay informed by following Alumni Relations on social media and visiting the Fleming College alumni webpage. Stay connected. Networking is one of your most powerful career development tools. So make sure your alumni record is current by updating it through our website or through our alumni office. And we invite you to volunteer, join us at events, and take advantage of the perks and discounts we have specifically secured for our graduates. We know you'll be a remarkable ambassador for Fleming College as you move forward in your lives and careers.
It is my privilege to announce the winner of the Governor General of Canada Award. This special award of a collegiate bronze medal is awarded to the student who achieves the highest overall grade point average from a diploma level program. This year's winner is Cassandra Trotter of the School of Business. Shelley York, our accounting program coordinator, describes Cassandra as a quiet and unassuming leader who is exceptionally determined to master any topic. She's not just satisfied with getting good grades, but truly understanding the how and why of everything. Cassandra is taking advantage of her pathway to a CPA designation and will be continuing her studies this fall at Trent University. Congratulations, Cassandra, on this remarkable achievement. We are incredibly proud of you and wish you continued success as you work towards your CPA designation. Next, I'm very honored to introduce our valedictorians for 2020. Our valedictorians are chosen not only on the basis of their academic achievement, but also on their overall contribution to the student experience at Fleming, inside the classroom and outside the classroom, including their contributions to our communities. Being a valedictorian is an honor that our graduates will carry with them the rest of their lives. Our valedictorian for the School of Environmental and Natural Resource Science is Reiner Kirk Dinkelman.
Good morning, all you wonderful graduates. My name is Reiner Kirk Dinkelman, and I'm this year's graduating class valedictorian. I'm so thrilled to be able to speak with you today, and how sad is it that we can't be doing this in person? Nonetheless, I hope you've all been productive with your extra free time that we've had during the pandemic. I know I have been. I've been speccing motorcycles, shopping online, catching up on TV shows. Okay, maybe not quite as productive as I could have been, but at least I'm caught up on Netflix. Joking aside, congratulations on your fantastic achievement. Graduating college really is a big deal. It takes a lot of hard work, and I hope you are all looking forward to this exciting new chapter in your lives. There are two things I want to share with you that I've learned during my time at Fleming, and especially in the past couple of months. Firstly, push yourself and step outside of your comfort zone when you can. This is something that has gotten me so far in the past year and a half since I started my time at Fleming. I've had such incredible experiences, not only with people at Fleming, but also with employers and people in my field who want me on their teams. And it's because I put myself out there. Secondly, try to show appreciation for those that support you and help you along in life. There are a number of people who I absolutely want to take a moment to give thanks to. Firstly, thank you to you, my fellow students. Without you, I wouldn't be where I am, nor would I have been able to achieve what I did. You have been such a motivation for me, and it has been a pleasure getting to know some of you like I have. Secondly, a huge round of applause to my teachers and the staff at Fleming, especially the forestry faculty. This has been a far more incredible post-secondary experience than I could have ever imagined, and a big part of that is because of the support and the care that I felt from the staff at Fleming College. Scott, Ben, Tim, Nicole, Tom, Katrina, Barb, Josh, Mike Fraser, obviously can't forget that guy, Jeff, Peter, Deanna, Dan, Derek, Juliet, Adele, and whoever else I missed, I'm sorry, you are all incredible. And finally, thank you to my wife, of course, and my family, who has been nothing but supportive the entire time I've been at Fleming. The ending thought I want to leave you with is from a piece in Theodore Roosevelt's The Man in the Arena, and it goes something like this. It is not the critic who counts, not the person who points out how the strong person stumbles, or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the person who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes short again and again, because there is no effort without error and shortcoming, but who does actually strive to do the deeds, who knows great enthusiasms, the great devotions, who spends themselves in a worthy cause, who at the best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if they fail, at least fail while daring greatly, so that their place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who neither know victory nor defeat. Farewell, my friends. I wish you all the best in your future endeavors, and I hope our paths will cross again.
I would like to next call on our registrar, Ronnie Serdick, for the formal conferral of diplomas and certificates.
Madam President, it is my privilege to report to you that the candidates listed in this ceremony have qualified in all respects for diplomas or certificates by successfully completing the curriculum offered by Sir Sanford Fleming College. The faculty have recommended that they be awarded diplomas or certificates in recognition of their academic accomplishments.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Governors of Sir Sanford Fleming College, I do hereby confer on your respective diploma or certificate with all the honors, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Congratulations, graduating students. Congratulations on your efforts and on your accomplishments. I'm confident that they have the skills required to tackle the challenges ahead and that you will do great things in your life.
Class of 2020, congratulations. You did it. You're now a graduate of Fleming College. You've had a year filled with adversity and you have come through it with such resilience. We know that you will go out into the world and do amazing things, and we can't wait to hear from you and about you. Congratulations. You've made us very proud.
Hi, this is Brett Goodwin, Vice President of Applied Research and Innovation at Fleming College. I started the year as the Dean of Centers. I just want to give a special congratulations to all our Centers graduates. You've come through a challenging semester with a lot of resilience. Wishing you a bright and wonderful future as you take your skills out into the world.
Big congratulations to all the graduates of the School of Environmental and Natural Resource Sciences. My name is Tracy Finley. I'm mathematics faculty at Frost Campus. And congratulations to everybody. So exciting.
Hi, I'm Jonathan Carter from the Aquaculture Program at the Frost Campus. I just wanted to wish you congratulations on your graduation and wish you best of luck in your future endeavors. Thank you, good luck, and take care.
The day that we celebrate you, all of your hard work, determination, and effort have brought you to this point in your educational journey. May you all go out into this vast world of ours and be the shining lights that I know you all are. Congratulations.
Class of 2020, congratulations to you all. You made it and we are so proud. All the best, keep in touch, miss you, and we'll be thinking of you. Congratulations.
I'm so proud of your accomplishments. It's been a challenging year, but you've risen to that challenge, and I can't wait to see what amazing things you'll accomplish in the future. Always remember your Frost family will be here to celebrate you along the way.
Congratulations on behalf of the Fish and Wildlife faculty and staff.
It is my pleasure to say well done.
You face many challenges, and you've graduated with a Fish and Wildlife Diploma.
You are now a part of a vast network of Fish and Wildlife alumni,
working to conserve our precious resources across Canada and beyond.
Whether you are now pursuing a career in Fish and Wildlife,
or continuing with your own education,
we want to wish you all the best and good luck.
Keep in touch and remember your Fleming roots.
We're always interested in hearing about your adventures.
Dear graduates of 2020, I am so proud of all of the learning that you've accomplished, of the rocky ending to the term that you navigated, and of all of the amazing change you're about to create in the world. Today is your day to bask in the spotlight, so please add my congratulations to your list of well wishes and enjoy your celebrations wherever they're taking place.
Congratulations to the Arboriculture, Urban Forestry, and Forestry graduates.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
And now, I'd like to formally present the graduating class of 2020 with special recognition of our award winners and those students who have earned the Indigenous Perspectives designation.
How
I'm on top of the world. Tried to cut these corners, try to take the easy way. I kept on falling short of something. I could have gave up then, but then again I couldn't have, cause I've traveled all this way for something. I take it in, but don't look down.
I'm on top of the world.
Bye.
Take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. in, but don't look down.
'Cause I'm on top of the world, eh? I'm on top of the world, eh? Waiting on this for a while now. Paying my dues to the dirt. I've been waiting to smile, eh? Been holding it in for a while, eh? Take you with me if I can. Been dreaming of this since a child. I'm on top of the world.
I've tried to cut these corners.
We've now come to the end of Convocation, but before we close, I would like to once again acknowledge the hard work and tremendous efforts of each and every one of our graduates who have made it here today. And I would like to once again thank and congratulate our valedictorians and our award winners. Thank you for your invaluable contributions to Fleming College. You are all at an amazing place to be in your life. I also want to thank and acknowledge a few people involved in today's convocation. Dan Marinig, Chair of the Board of Governors, Ashley Safar and Mary McLeod Beaver for your Indigenous tribute to our graduates, to the staff in the Registrar's Office and our marketing team, as well as those around the college who have assisted with this event and throughout the year and in challenging times. And finally, thank you to all of our Fleming faculty and staff who have done a spectacular job in teaching and supporting students throughout some of the most trying times in 2020. And as I conclude, I'd like to impart a few words. Never forget who helped you along the way and who you will help. Your education is an important part of your arsenal, but never forget the relationships that you're developing along the way and sustaining. And graduates, always remember, you do you. Congratulations. It's my duty to announce the convocation is officially closed.